The names long ago became familiar to football fans. Jim Kelly, Thurman Thomas, Andre Reed, Bruce Smith, the coach, Marv Levy, all future Hall of Famers. Four AFC titles in succession, four crushing Super Bowl defeats. A team of remarkable character and resiliency, a team that's left a lasting mark on this era of professional football. The Buffalo Quintet spoke with Bob Costas.
Every window in my hometown is empty. And I really don't know why. And I am tired and I'm weary. And Lord, those gray skies bring me down. And I came home for just one reason, to find myself. Yeah, and I keep thinking, oh, I'm thinking, time's been unleashed, I don't want to leave you, so please give me one more try.
How often, if at all, do you think of any or all of the four Super Bowls?
I think about them a lot. You can't help but think about it. It's a situation where we had four opportunities and we blew it. The only thing that's in our minds right now is making it back so we could give it another opportunity and give it another shot at winning the Super Bowl.
I just know that being in all the Super Bowls, that we never had the chance to feel what it's like to be in the winning locker room. I know that you never know if you're ever going to have another opportunity to get back, and just the feeling in that locker room afterwards, we all say, boy, I hope we get another chance to get back in there and hopefully get the taste winning one.
And the Super Bowl will ride on the right foot of Norwood.
Of those four games, which, if any, should you have won?
You go ahead, Bruce, because I think you're wrong. Might say the same thing. You might all say the same thing. You go ahead. You be the spokesman.
I think the first one, without a doubt, sticks out in our minds the most.
Puts it down on the way. It's long enough, and it is no good. It was a heartbreaking way to lose it for the Bills.
The first one will always stick out of my mind as being the one we just let slip away.
Where else would you rather be? Right here.
I think after two of them, you kind of, oh man, just brings chills to me because you realize that the first one you should have won. It was a field goal. The second one, you're kind of outclassed.
One of the Super Bowl images I recall is your frustration in the game against Washington.
Unsportsmanlike conduct foul on number 83, Uffay.
That, I tell you, out of all four Super Bowls, I think that was the one we were probably outclassed the most.
How about Jim Galloway?
Thurman, part of being a pro athlete is the ability to forget. Forget what happened in years past. Forget what happened just a few days past. But it's easier to say it than to do it, isn't it?
No, much easier to say it than to do it. I when I go on the road with my teammates, you know, I'm always reminded of a lot of things. And most of the time, it's losing my helmet in the Super Bowl in 1991. And I'm still reminded about that. And I know people won't forget about that. And really, I won't forget about it.
How does a guy misplace his helmet at the Super Bowl?
It was Kenny Davis's fault. He moved it somewhere and it got lost.
Now, what does the coach say? When maybe the best running back in the conference is just the Super Bowl, you know, and hey, whoa, I don't have my helmet.
Yeah. Well, he didn't say too much.
He laid it down for the national anthem. Somebody moved it. You know, what the heck, it could happen to anyone. It happened to happen on national television in the Super Bowl, however.
My power, my pleasure, my pain.
How do you suppose your lives or your careers would have been different if you'd won even one of those games?
We might have won all of them. We could have, you know, by winning that one, it could have catapulted us even to bigger and better things the year after, and the year after that, and the year after that. We could have felt what it's like to win. And it just would have carried over.
we would have never been able to, if we would have won four Super Bowls, there's no way we would have been able to stay in the same locker room with Bruce.
No way, oh boy. I can just picture that right now.
You know, Bob, I don't look back, even with the losses, as sad moments. I'm speaking personally right now. I had the opportunity during that time and still to be with some wondrous people. Guys who I admired greatly, guys with great fighting hearts. I think of some of the things we did to get to some of those Super Bowls. One year we had a rally from a 35-3 deficit in the second half.
Incredible! What a comeback by the Bills!
And then go on and win games on the road in Pittsburgh and in Miami.
The question's going to be asked, what about your past losses? Say, hey, we're just getting ready to win the Super Bowl.
The chase is inspiring, and what this team accomplished is something I'll never forget, and I'll remember fondly. Now, we're talking in a mode of reminiscence. We're still looking ahead to going back, and maybe someday you'll come back and talk to the five of us again about what it was like to win that game.
The Buffalo Bills discussing the past. It's time to look to the immediate future. Back with more from the Buffalo Bills right after this. Levy, Thurman Thomas, and Bruce Smith. The Buffalo Bills talk about a trying season and the continuing quest. Here they are again with Bob Costas.
Does it run through any of your minds? Some of the guys who went to war with you in the glory years are gone already. This is what remains of the core of those teams. That this could be the last go-round for a great team?
I've been hearing that for three or four years now.
1991, too.
I know we still have the tools. Injuries have hurt us this year, there's no doubt. But I know deep down inside, the attitude is still there, and the willingness to go out and keep fighting and keep winning is still there, and that's all you can really ask. Everybody's always counting us out, and the Bills lose three games, they're gone, they're done, you know, no more. But, you know, I can say for everybody, we have so much resiliency and so much fight in us that if you back us up in a corner, we're always going to come out fighting.
What a competitor. What a competitor this kid is.
Let me ask you to be reflective about yourself a little bit, Marv. Although you don't look it, you're 71 years old. You've been around the game for a long time. Isn't that shocking? I deny the allegation.
There are rumors of the truth being spread.
He denies the allegation. 71 years old, not too long ago, had a bout with prostate cancer, and yet you still seem, as you sit here, you really have a passion for it. It's not a task, it's something you're looking forward to.
Well, I enjoy it, every minute of it. I enjoy the association with the people, as I say, several of them are right here.
Thank you, fellas. Thank you.
Jim, you're now 36 years old.
Thanks.
Better 71.
Let's take roll. 36, 71.
33.
33.
We'll be 33.
30.
Well, these are
Marv, you ready to go?
Used to say that this team might not get to another Super Bowl, might not eventually win a Super Bowl. But if you never win a Super Bowl, what's a fair way for the Buffalo Bills, this era of the Buffalo Bills, to be remembered?
A resilient bunch of guys that never wanted to quit.
I think Marv put it best in a number of team meetings that he spoke to us with this scenario. He said that he wants players that are motivated from within.
That's turning heat up.
This is your job. This is your livelihood. If you can't do that, then you're in the wrong line of work.
Okay, good evening, America. We have a pretty good show in store for you tonight.
When I leave this game, I'll know that I was on the stage four times. You know, I didn't perform. We didn't perform like we wanted to, but there's guys that played 10, 11 years. We'll never get on that stage.
I think a fair legacy for this football team would be you couldn't call us losers. You can call us a bunch of guys who tried their heart, gave it their all to go out to try to win a Super Bowl.
Don't let them fool you with the past ones. You earned your way here magnificently.
If this team were to win a Super Bowl game, my memory of them would be no fonder than it is if they don't.
One of the more unfortunate but very real aspects of professional sports and the National Football League and Super Bowls is that the Buffalo Bills will probably be remembered more for losing four consecutive Super Bowls, Joe Gibbs, than for making it to four straight.
Let's think about what kind of an accomplishment it is just to get to a Super Bowl. I've experienced that. We were there four times. We won three of them. Everybody remembers those ones that we won. Man, it was fantastic. That 83 team that we lost the Super Bowl in was probably, arguably, our best football team. People really picture that team as, hey, it's a loser. It lost. Now, that's life in the NFL. Is it right? No, it's not right. But that's the life you live, and I think that's the feeling that these guys are experiencing right here.
Well, you take the Packers of the 60s. The Cowboys become the losers because they lost the Packers. Then you go into the 70s. The Steelers are the winners. The Cowboys are the losers again. Then you go into the 80s. The 49ers are the winners. Then you go into the 90s. The Cowboys are the winners. The Bills are the losers. There are no losers. When you get to the Super Bowl, you've achieved a tremendous thing. It's unfortunate that they lost four in a row, but very few teams in the history of the game have gone to four in a row, and they got to be applauded for that.
When Mike mentioned the 80s, that was your cue.
That's all.
And he flashed
that ring right in my face, too.
Do you wear your runner-up ring at all the AFC or NFC championship ring?
In Europe.
It's depressing, isn't it?
Yeah.
You go out to a party and people come up and say, oh, that's nice. What is this, Super Bowl ring? I didn't know you won a Super Bowl. Well, we didn't. It's the runner-up ring. And then the whole thing just deteriorates, goes down. Then you fumble in that game. Yeah, you know, I throw it in the drawer. I never wear it.
But we have no chance to try to win a Super Bowl. Buffalo still has a chance.
They do. And this is a team that... they've lost three in a row, but they've lost in two domes and in Miami. This is a cold weather team. All the AFC playoff games are going to be in cold weather. I still think they've got a shot.
All of you guys, 6-7 in Super Bowls, that's pretty good representation. We'll take a timeout. We're back with the Honda Pick of the Week right after this.